Good day, you're welcome to Lush Fashion. Today we'll be looking at how to make this gorgeous overlap skirt. Draft and cut out our pattern, our skirt pattern. The lining is 1 inch shorter, like you can see. It's a pencil skirt pattern, so you can see what the pencil skirt pattern looks like. Then we mark our darts like so. Ensure you mark on the lining and the fabric. We've sewn the darts, you can see this is what the sewn darts looks like. Next, we are going to pull the lining to the base and sew with 0.5 inch after pinning. Do the same to the front and the back of the skirt. After that, pull it upward and pin the center, then sew the center. After sewing, measure your slit and mark. Slit is 6 inch. Then we measure 1 inch for zip allowance. We'll sew the zip allowance after pinning with 1 inch. So this is what it looks like after sewing. Next, we are going to fix our zip. So you pin your zip and fix your zip. After pinning, then you sew the zip. I'm going to trace out the skirt as a front part of the skirt. I'm going to trace it out on a pattern paper. Before your side seam allowance, measure 8.5 inch for the width of the big overlap, then 2.5 inch for the extension that will go outward, then connect back to that end. Then you go upward, measure 1 inch. Turn the tape and measure 2 inch and mark. Connect the 1 inch to the 2 inch at the side. Then measure 1 inch again. Then measure about 4 inches. You measure 2 inch inwards and use a curved ruler to connect the line. Then use a ruler to connect that line straight down, like so. Just connect and blend straight. Now you are going to measure 5 inch. Move your tape, then measure 5 inch again and connect with your curved ruler at a side that is not so curvy. Measure 5 inch from the waist, mark and curve. Curve a bit downwards. Ensure it doesn't curve too deep inwards. Then connect to the base. Another pattern paper, trace out the smaller one. You are going to trace out exactly what you have at that end. Trace it out like so. Then you measure about 4.5 for the width at the base, 3 inch for the curve. Then measure 7 inch. You mark your 3 inch, then 2.5 at the waist itself. So you connect all the lines with your curve ruler and straight ruler at this point. We have 6 inch distance between the big overlap and the small one. So we are going to cut out our pattern for the overlap, the small one, like so. So just cut out. So after cutting the bead, you have this for the big and small overlap. We've cut the fabric and lining. Then we are going to cut gum stay and iron at the back side, so you can see. So I'm going to place the lining on the big overlap and sew like this. So 6 inch we left and sew the 6 inch. Then we'll sew the small one, place the lining on it, pin and sew like so. So we've sewn it and this is what it looks like. You can see we've sewn the big one and the 6 inch overlap, you can see. So we'll place it on this front part of the skirt. You can see the distance we have at that end. Then measure that it doesn't extend to your side seam allowance on at the upper and the lower parts. So we are marking the curved parts. Place both on each other and mark. Then you turn like this because we are going to sew over it following that line. So ensure you mark the line well. So we are going to sew over it following that line. I'm pinning over the line I marked. So pin carefully because of the gum stay, it's quite hard. So you pin carefully and stop before your 6 inch. You are not going to sew over the 6 inch allowance. So I've sewn and you can see what it looks like. I didn't sew over. I'm going to top stitch over the 6 inch. So I've top stitched. So I'm going to sew the sides of the skirts now. Start by marking your waist divided by 2. Next you mark your waist to hip, then your hip line divided by 2, then the base hip line divided by 2 minus 1. You connect the lines and sew. So it's on the side, you can see the length of the band is 1.5. The width is the waist of the skirt.